Prior to my presentation, Vicente asked me to show you all some items, some of the best items for Presbyopia, the last ASCRS. And I told him that it were not possible, and I give another item for in order to present here today. But in preparing for the symposium of this Congress, that is the best of the ASCRS, I saw some things for presbyopia that I think is more interesting. The interest is higher than the previous thing that I were in order to develop. There is one highlight of the last ASCRS, that is the EDOF. A new concept is born, and all new concept is born for the presbyopia field. The EDOF, the extended depth of focus, is well known on the traditional optics, because all the pinhole systems, as I show you later, is a very, very ancient optical technique in order to achieve a very good visual acuity. But if we want to reach a good extended depth of focus, we have two options, the pinhole systems, and also we can play with the chromatic aberration. The pinhole is a very old concept. It is from Moody, a Chinese philosopher, 500 years before Christ, described the pinhole, the first pinhole system, in order to reach better visual acuity. Also, is known with Leonardo da Vinci, the 15th century. He discovered the dark chamber, a very well known concept for photography. That is also a pinhole system that give double focus. All people who know some of the photography knows that we can have the closing the diaphragm, we can obtain a very depth of focus. That idea is very useful in order to correct some refractive defects and also to give a very good visual acuity for near vision. That is, for example, the main principle of the cataract focus, that is an stereopaic pinhole system, optical system. And in this moment, a new lens is born also, the AcuFocus IOL, that is the same camera but at the intraocular lens. The trials are starting in Mexico, Pancho Sánchez León. Here we can talk about his own experience with this lens. Isn't that lens that gives vision for far near and intermediate vision with a very good results in a monocular system. Also, but not exactly for presbyopic pupils, the Trinidad pinhole, a winner of the film festival, has this black but transparent to the infrared vision. This pinhole lens, designed by Fernando Trinidad Belo Horizonte, Brazil, we can correct in an add-on system some very high ice, very aberrated, as you can see in this technique. It's possible that in the future that could be one of the pinhole systems in order to correct some perspective effects. Well, the other option to obtain EDOF extended depth of focus is to play with the chromatic aberrations. With chromatic aberrations, we can play with two different optical systems, diffracting and refracting. The combination of that can allows to obtain a very good extended depth of focus. And that is is not for irregular lenses. That is, for example, this is a teleobjective from Canon. The DO is diffractive optic. It's made with systems combining diffractive and refractive lenses in order to achieve very good depth of focus. Probably this year, the ICL launched with a system not known exactly that we play with this system in order to obtain the extended double focus to correct in an adult system with a faking lens the possibility to correct presbyopia at the 50s. Well, and the last for this, but not exclusively, is the Symphony lenses that Ramon Ruiz Mesa told previously, and there is some other talks. That is the lens, but the lens plays with working with chromatic aberration and also with elongated steps or the diffractive steps called excellent. That can give a very good far intermediate and so near vision that this is a new good device for this. This is comparing the focus curve, comparing with trifocal as fine vision or two bifocal Abbott lenses with a low addition. That is the focus curve of that Symphony. So there is probably a new concept in order to correct presbyopia and other refractive problems of the eye with the pinhole system and the combination with the chromatic aberration. Thank you very much for your attention.